We just left an event. Today was Mom's Day. Yes, I'm talking to my camera. Today was Mom's Day. I had a day with my friend Mika.
Hi.
There she is.
Hi.
So we had a day. We went to brunch and then we went to a live podcast taping. So we went to Brunch and Beats, which was fun. How would you rate it, Mika?
Brunch and Beats?
Yes.
Brunch and Beats was like a whole 8.5, 9 out of 10.
8.5, 9 out of 10. So I managed to get some shots. So here are the shots for Brunch and Beats.
Yeah.
So then after we did brunch and beats, I'm trying to get the light up and it won't work. After we did brunch and beats, no, I don't need that. It's fine. It was just this black and that. After we did brunch and beats, we came to Adulting Podcast Live taping, which was also good. Mika, how would you rate that?
Adulting, I would rate it 6.5 to 7 out of 10.
It's a different concept down here. I don't think we don't have many podcasts that I know of recorded in St. Martin. So this was a live taping of a podcast, Adulting. So it was interesting. It was interesting to see it put together, what would be the end product and how they did it. I think it was fairly decent. I think I probably do about a 7 or 8 also, just because I understand how things also work behind the scenes to get something together, to put it on top and to be a part of it. So I think they did pretty decent. But these are a few shots that I caught of that. Check it out.
If you have seen some of the episodes already, and basically tonight is a live version of what you've seen on YouTube. Memphis Aragon! What's going on, brother? Everything good? Christian Granum! The one, the only, King Purse is here in the building. That's good.
What he had to do as a man, you understand? And unfortunately for me, at this age, maybe last year, a little younger than I realized I ain't had a father-son relationship like what you see on TV and like verse it. You hear your friends brag about, yeah, I did this with my father this weekend, I went here with my father this weekend. And for me, it's like, those are stuff that I missed, that I wanted and I didn't get. So, like, I still affected even growing up in a comfortable home and having everything except my father there, like, when I needed him the most, you understand? And I ain't saying, like, he wasn't there. I just mean, like, things that I wish I had then, I didn't, like, know that I realized I ain't had it. It's like, yo. I have friends that say they went fishing with their father. I went fishing with my friends and their father, and I realized, like, yo, this is cool. I wish I'd do this with my father when I was younger. You understand?
I understand this now. But you ever notice your husband grumpy for no reason?
Yeah.
He's your boyfriend, your partner. He just grumpy. He like, what you grumpy? And he like, nothing. Nothing. And the minute you back it up and he go, ugh. He like, what you need, baby? Can I help you? Let me take care of that. You like, I got this? Yes. Because we don't care. We don't care.
After you do.
That's it. I'll tell you.
And then
you get a host baby.
Gonna be grumpy.
Why is she grumpy?
I mean, because women like cuddling.
Yeah, but that ain't emotional. That's still physical. So that's physical.
And there's communication. There's communication in physical intimacy, right? So when you physically intimate with somebody,
that's it. That's everything. That's it. Love. Both parents are present, involved. My parents were there. They're still there. Please. I grew up in a comfortable home. I didn't need anything. My parents provided, my father for sure provided. He made sure that his wife and his children always had. And in order for him to do that, he had to work long hours. Most days I was either in school, when he comes home, I either get ready for bed, or he come home for like a fast lunch or whatever if I did.
It's a great thing. When somebody comes to you aggressive, you have to be the one to, you know, level the playing field and be like, calm the situation down, because answering back with aggression, it nobody gets anywhere. You know, so I think that's one of my assets that I feel that makes me, at least as an adult.
Sir, kindly calm the fuck down. Calm down. It's okay.
Accountability and responsibility by a woman to say, Christian, this is what I expect from you. Christian, this is what I expect from you. And also uncommunicated expectations are given to me. Where you internalize expectations and now do something with it, then. Exactly, because there's things that women just feel that men should know.
Check this, right? At the same day, you have a lot of women. You have a lot of women that are on certain chapters of their life that encounter or interact with men that are so immature. You know what I mean? And they deal with those men and they try their best to bring those men up and just only realize that they're frustrating themselves, right? And they don't realize that because that man keep fucking up, that man keep waiting.
I think we did.
Comfortable? He ain't about to relax. He ain't about to show up no more. He ain't giving no problems no more. He ain't showing up on the music no more. And that's where it goes down the drain. Wait, ladies. Because we're taking it to the way. On the first 6 months, y'all motherfuckers showed up with the prettiest lingerie.
Johnson Jones, December 31st.